What's up, people? It's Twiz Vegin. I am back. It's been, I think, almost 11 months since I posted a video, but we have a good reason to post a video. We're here in Spokane, Washington, Riley and I, and we have some vegan adventures that's going on, and we want to bring you what's on the scene here and what we've experienced with just two nights in Spokane. Damn it. So we are currently walking through the riverfront on the Spokane River, and it is, let me tell you, gorgeous. But this morning I had an oat milk latte from First Avenue Coffee, and man, it was good. And the barista who made it for me also put in a tiny bit of his homemade vegan caramel sauce that he makes out of coconut. Bizarre. It was so good, highly recommend it. Lovely latte, yum, yes. For dinner, I went to Root, and that was a small little vegan cafe, all vegan, and I had the barbecue chickpea salad. I opened that thing up, it was like Christmas morning. It had the barbecue chickpea glaze and sauce, pickled red onions, this creamy dill dressing, chickpea ranch crumbles, like some type of like breadcrumby almost. It was so good. Cucumbers, all the flavors were just working. It was working overtime. I wish I was here for probably the next week so I could eat there every day. So next up on my things to try is some ice cream from The Scoop, and they have a few vegan flavors, so I'm gonna go see what they have today and give it a try. This right here, it's the truth. So good. Just walking back to the hotel, about to wrap this video up. Yum. So overall thoughts of Spokane, Washington. My God, is it beautiful? The city, the outskirts of the city, so much things to do. The vegan food scene was not bad here. Granted, I'm only here for two nights. I wish I was staying a little bit longer, but we on to Seattle. If you haven't been to Spokane, go to Spokane. It's for everybody. It was amazing. Bye. So it is my last morning in Spokane, and of course, I had to get another thing of coffee. So we're gonna try Indaba. We'll see how it goes. So I ordered a large oat milk latte, and it is creamy. The espresso has a nice nutty finish to it. But with all bouginess aside, the place was beautiful inside. The coffee is delicious. And I didn't ask if they had any other non-dairy milks, but oat milk was all I cared about, so you know. It's so good that I feel like I'm inhaling it, so I need to slow down. I had my Indaba. While I was in there, I just kind of had this vibe that they were about more. I like companies that have a story, because I'm all about the stories. They're all about radical hospitality. You know, their whole tagline is love people, love coffee. This whole idea behind Indaba, what it actually is a South African Zulu word that stands for a gathering of leaders, and in particularly to discuss an important matter. The CEO and founder really wanted to do was bring people from different socioeconomic statuses, different ethnicities, races together to have important conversations and have it be an open space where people can feel like they can do that. I highly recommend Indaba. Spark up some conversation if you're in there and you're here in Spokane. That's it, y'all. I'm on my way to Seattle. I'm sure there'll be more videos soon. Peace. Peace. Peace, 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 peace.